If you're trying to use your TV to watch some movies or fire up the Xbox or PlayStation for some gaming, powered from your mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system, you need to know how much power those devices use on a day-to-day basis so you can size your batteries and solar appropriately. And that's exactly what I'm going to teach you here in lesson number 4 of this electrical system sizing playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, the methods of estimating power usage that I'm going to teach you in this video will work for nearly everything that you can plug into a standard household wall outlet. So, if you keep an open mind and think critically, you'll be able to apply this information to your own specific project. Last thing before we get started. I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below, so be sure to scroll down and check it out. Let's get started. How much power does a gaming console use? A TV, a PlayStation, an Xbox, or really anything else that plugs into a standard household wall outlet is rated to operate at a certain number of watts. My Xbox Series X has a 315-watt power supply inside of it based on a few Google searches. Now, I could theoretically just multiply the watts of the device times how long I'm playing to get the watt hours used, which would work, but would be an overestimate, and I want to show you a more accurate way. Devices like these aren't using their full rated wattage at all time, or even very often. More often than not, they're just using a fraction of this rating. And I actually stumbled across this article by Microsoft where they tested the Xbox at various times during gameplay. For example, the main menu, the pause screen, active rendering, and loading screens all have different power consumptions, anywhere from 70 watts to 150 watts. And these numbers change depending on what game is being played and how graphically demanding it is. So to try to say, well, I plan on gaming for 2 hours tonight with 5% of time spent on a pause screen, which is 70 watts, and then another 10% in loading screens, which is 74 watts, and then the remaining time in active gameplay and cutscenes, which is 146 watts and 95 watts respectively. Well, those calculations just simply aren't reasonable unless you just like doing math unnecessarily, which if you do, more power to you, but that's not what we're going to do here. So here's how to actually figure out how much power our PlayStation, Xbox, or TV uses. Now last night I plugged in a power strip into the power meter and turned on the TV and Xbox Series X and hunted a 3-star badger for about 2 hours to craft my Legends of the East satchel, which after those 2 hours of play, this resulted in 0.629 kilowatt hours of power draw being shown on the meter. Now moving the decimal 3 places to the right to convert from kilowatt hours to watt hours gives me a result of 629 watt hours being used. Now in the context of an off-grid battery bank, if this power were being drawn from a 12 volt battery bank, 629 watt hours divided by 12 volts results in 52 amp hours, which is 52% of a 100 amp hour 12 volt battery for those 2 hours of Xbox and TV usage. Now, before we wrap up this video, I want to hear from you. Once you've had a chance to measure how much power your TV, video game console, or whatever device you're measuring uses, let me know down in the comment section below. Let me know what you're powering, how long you're powering it for, and how much power it used so we can all learn together. Now you should have a pretty good idea of how to calculate the power used by a TV, Xbox, PlayStation, or most any other kind of entertainment system in a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system. And we will refer to this video later in the academy when we discuss full power audits, so be sure to bookmark it for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher. In the next lesson, I'm going to teach you how to determine the power required for an off-grid powered electric space heater and why it's generally not a good idea to use one. So click up here to watch that, and I'll see you over there.